Hey everyone, welcome back. It's time for the latest GoSkills Challenge Solution. How did you do? Well, we're about to find out. Our Excel expert Claudia Buckley has her solution to share. Give it a look and see if yours matches up.
Our monthly expense sheet is made up of several Excel tables that carry a column to show whether we're spending more or less money this month compared with last month. We want to spend less, so our conditional format will show more spending in a red font color and less spending in green. So first, let's find the difference here by going to the difference column, and we want to find out whether we spent more or less this month. Notice what happened here. This is an Excel table, so the formulas automatically got copied to the remaining rows in the column. And that's just one of the advantages of using an Excel table. How do we apply conditional formatting? We just need to highlight that difference column. That's the range of cells where we want conditional formatting applied. Go to the conditional formatting command. We wanted to get the font color changed, and we also want to apply icon sets. Now, it doesn't matter in this case which one we do first, so let's do the highlight cells rules. For cells that are greater than 0, we want the font color to be red. Now, there's a default where the font color and the cell fill is red, but that's not what we asked for. So we can do red text here, and that's one condition. Let's do another. For values that are less than 0, we want those to be in green font color. So we need to customize that format, get the color to green. And here we go. Now we need another set of conditional formatting applied. That's the icon sets. So we go back to the conditional formatting command, select icon sets, and we needed the traffic light icon sets. That's these three. Now here Excel applied its default condition, which doesn't coincide with the ones we want. So we need to go back to conditional formatting and manage the rule. We make sure that the icon set rule is highlighted, and then we hit edit rule. So now we need to take a look at these values, which were set to percentages. Let's change that to number. And we want, if the cell value is greater than 0, we want this icon to be red. And let's change this one to a number also. And for the last one, we want this change to green. So if the difference is a negative value, then that's good, because it means we're spending less. And of course, if it's exactly 0, then we want the amber light applied. We can represent that by choosing less than or equal to 0 and greater than or equal to 0. We can hit apply. We can see that our icon sets are applied immediately. So let's hit OK, and this looks great. Now the subtotal row is still showing blank, so we can just fix that right now. We need a sum here. And again, because this is an Excel table, it makes summarizing this data super easy. And now we just need to go through and do the same thing for each table. Now that we have the difference column filled in for all these tables, we just need to get the conditional formatting filled in. So let's highlight what we have here. Control C to copy. Highlight each difference column and copy the conditional formatting. So now we've highlighted each difference column, and we just need to right-click and paste the conditional formatting. And this beautifully copies all the conditional formatting rules we created. And if we were to add rows to any of these tables, the same conditional formatting would be applied. We can experiment with that right here. Let's call it other 2. And here, we see that the icon set was copied. So that looks great. Let's delete this row because we don't need it. Now all that's left is to get the subtotals from each respective table. So we repeat that action here by going to the subtotal row and selecting the sum. Well, our second task was to go to the summary table and create a chart that's based on the subtotal row of each expense. And for that, we'll need the expense name filled in to the first column, that's the category column, and we can manually enter that. We do have a list of all the table names here, so we could just type those in by looking at the name box. And we can just grab the subtotals from each table. So this is last month, and we go through and do the same for the other seven tables. We know that for each table, the this month column is to the immediate right of last month, so we can just drag to copy. And now we're on to task number three. We want a chart that's dynamic so that if values are added to this data set, the chart gets updated. The simplest way to do this is to make this chart into an Excel table. To create an Excel table, you can go to the Home tab, click Format as Table, and choose from any of the table styles here. Or you could just click anywhere within the data set. Control T, make sure that Excel is selecting the right area for your table. Choose My Table Has Headers, because ours does in row number 2. Hit OK. And Excel formats this to a table. It gives us a default table name, but let's create our own. Let's call it Summary and enter. Now to create the bar or column chart, we can do Insert and choose from one of these charts here. Or we could just do Alt F1 and Excel will create a chart that it thinks is appropriate for our data type. All right, to get this chart a little more organized, maybe we could sort by the value of this month's expenses. So let's sort largest to smallest, and we should give our chart a title. Okay, so how do we know if this chart really is dynamic? Well, if we add a value to the end of the source data, we want to see it show up on this chart automatically. So let's say we started working from home, and now we have our home office. And that's going to be our new expense. So let's go over to our monthly expense worksheet. And maybe we can just copy this table. Call this our work expense. And we need furniture and a laptop. Of course, last month, there were zero expenses in this category. But this month we spent $230 for furniture, maybe $450 for a laptop, and no other expenses. So we've got everything here, and it is a table, but because we used the food table to create this one, then Excel assigned a name. Let's make it a more appropriate name. Let's call it work. And that's the name of our new table. So now we want to see that data in our summary sheet. We just need to tab after the last row, enter the name of our last category, and grab the subtotals from our new table. And of course, it shows up on our column chart. Now, we wouldn't have been able to do this if we just use a regular range to create our summary. When Excel tables expand or contract, so do the charts that are linked to them. Of course, there's no one way to do anything in Excel, so maybe you used another method. Like, maybe you listed those tables exactly as they were named, then use the indirect function to return their subtotals. Or maybe you use some version of dynamic arrays. Tell us what other ways you can think of to solve this challenge and share it with us on our Slack channel. See you next time.
So there it is. Did you get the same results? Did you use the same approach? Or did you try something different? We'd like to know. Share your take on the challenge in the comments below or join us for more discussion in our Slack channel. Link in the description. Thanks for participating and make sure to subscribe to this channel to get an alert when the next challenge is released. We'll see you then.